So Webflow just dropped one of their biggest announcements in years, and some of it actually matters for us freelancers and designers. I spent the last couple hours going through everything they announced at Webflow Conf 2025, so you don't have to. Let me break down what's real, what's hype, and what you should actually care about. Look, I'm going to be straight with you. Webflow conferences are notorious for over-promising and under-delivering. Remember Webflow Logic? Yeah, they're killing that. But this year feels different. They're making moves that could really change how we work, if they execute it properly. The theme was AI native website experience platform, which sounds like a lot of corporate buzzword bingo, to be honest, but underneath the marketing speak, there are some real opportunities here. First, the big one, the revamped AI assistant. Now, before you roll your eyes, this isn't another AI will do everything for you pitch. What they're showing is more like having a junior developer who actually understands your project. So here's what matters. It knows your site structure, your CMS content, and your existing styles. So instead of generic AI responses, it can actually suggest real changes that matter for your specific site. Think less ChatGPT and more like a content-aware design assistant. The reality check, it's coming later in 2025 with no specific date yet. We've all heard that before from Webflow. But if this works as demonstrated, it could genuinely speed up the mundane parts of our workflow, like updating repetitive content and so on. For freelancers, this could mean that you can actually complete your projects much faster. For agencies, this could help junior team members punch above their weight. But let's see the actual implementation before we get all excited here. Here's where it gets interesting. They announced AI code generation directly in Webflow. This can create full web applications and React components. So this isn't just generate some CSS. They are talking about building interactive dashboards, calculators, booking systems, and all that with a simple prompt. So what does this mean for us? Potentially, we could offer clients way more functionality without hiring any developers. That client who wants a custom ROI calculator, you might be able to deliver it yourself. The catch? It's not coming until early 2026, and it's built on their partnership with Astro. So we are probably waiting for another year, and let's see how well they integrate these technologies. But just think about the positioning opportunity. While other designers are stuck with basic websites, you could be delivering web applications. That's a whole different pricing conversation with clients. Number three, real-time collaboration, finally. This one's huge for agency work. Figma-style real-time collaboration right inside the Webflow designer. Multiple people can work on the same project simultaneously. If you've ever tried to coordinate with a copywriter or another designer on a Webflow project, you know the pain of who has the control of the designer at the moment. This solves that. For freelancers working with clients or contractors, this opens up new possibilities. For agencies, it could significantly speed up project delivery. The timeline, it's in private beta right now and will ship sometime end 2025. This one I'm cautiously optimistic about. Because the technology already exists, they're just implementing it. And now number four, or what they call next-gen CMS, they're rebuilding their CMS from the ground up. Higher limits on collections, better nesting, custom storage for large datasets. Translation, you can finally build those content-heavy sites that clients keep asking you for. The ones where you currently have to say, well, Webflow has limits. Plus, they're opening up the content delivery API to everyone and not just enterprise customers. This means you can use Webflow as a content hub for multiple touchpoints, website, mobile app, email campaigns, whatever. For those of you doing content-heavy work or managing multiple client sites, this could be significant. But again, end of 2025 timeline. And now number five, code components. This one's available right now, which is refreshing. You can import custom React components directly into Webflow and use them like native elements. What this means, if you know a developer or if you're dev curious yourself, you can extend Webflow's capabilities with custom widgets, integrations, whatever, and then use and reuse those components across your projects. This is available immediately if you're on a CMS or business site plan. It's a real feature shipping now that actually works, which is super cool. For freelancers, this could differentiate your service offering. For agencies, it's a way to create your own custom tools and components. So now let's talk about the elephant in the room. Webflow's 2025 pricing changes have been controversial so far. The new workspace model is more flexible, but also more complex. But the good news, you can have unlimited collaborators with different permission levels. The challenging news, some things that used to be free now cost money. For example, in some cases, a previously free editor may now require a paid seat. For freelancers, client handoffs might get more expensive. For agencies, the new model might actually save money if you have a larger team. My take, the pricing reflects Webflow's move towards enterprise. They want enterprise customers and they're willing to risk losing some solo freelancers to get them. What this actually means for us. Here's the real opportunity. Webflow is positioning itself as a platform to build complex AI-powered websites. Compare that to something like Framer that is more focused on building visually stunning websites. If these features deliver as promised, the gap between web designer and web developer starts to blur. You could potentially offer services that currently require a development team. But, and this is important, most of these features are 6 to 12 months away. Don't change your business model based on promises. So what can you do right now? Experiment with the code components feature if you're on the right plan. I will do so as well. And also think about positioning yourself for more complex projects. Instead of offering to build simple landing pages, you can offer to build more complex web apps like booking tools and so on, which can make you a lot more money, basically. And so to wrap this up, Webflow has a track record of overpromising at conferences, but they also have a track record of eventually delivering, even if it takes longer than expected. Maybe you know another company who does that. What are your thoughts on these announcements? Let me know in the comments. And also a lot of people have telling me that my Webflow videos are very helpful, so I've put together a special playlist that you can check out after this video, and I'll see you in the next one.